A third of the razor blades that we bought last year have been returned to Razor for diagnosis or repair, and still more are suffering from ongoing issues. So today's video is about two things: the 4K blade update that dropped this summer, and whether any of the issues that we've encountered with past blades are present on it. Speaking of issues, Sennheiser can solve them. That is, assuming your issues are specifically to do with needing a new pair of IEMs. Their HD1 wireless in-ears feature a sleek design, great sound performance, and a ton of awesome features. Check them out at the link below. The main attraction of the new blade is, of course, the upgrade from a 3200 by 1800 to a 4K display. And it's a significant improvement, though maybe not for the reasons you'd think. More on that later. There are some other things I want to get to first. The last generation Core i7 6700HQ CPU has been replaced by the faster Core i7 7700HQ, and the Blade V5's dual channel— No. No, wait, what? V5? Oh my god! I won! Razor finally got tired of the confusion! Sorry about that. Anyway, like I was saying, Blade V5's dual channel DDR4 2133 gets bumped up to 2400 megahertz for Blade B6. But other than that, not much has changed as far as I can tell. The reviewer's guide contains some, in my opinion, fairly misleading fluff about a lighter chassis, brighter keyboard, and improved thermal design, but when I questioned Razer about this, they admitted the chassis itself was unchanged, the thermal solution change was just an updated software fan curve, and this one's the kicker, the brighter keyboard bit was meant to be compared to a notebook without chroma backlighting. Excuse me? Now, they've assured me since then that this messaging was never used on the actual product page, and that they're going to send updated reviewer's guides to me and everyone who received one, but frankly, that still really sucks. Unless everyone goes back and updates their articles, videos, and streams, that misinformation is still going to be out there. This review from TechSpot, for example, quotes the weight of the 1080p and 4K models from the reviewer's guide. But while the new 4K model is lighter than the old QHD Plus model, this small difference seems to be because the display assembly was changed, possibly without adjusting the hinge because I can't open the notebook with one finger anymore, not because the chassis is lighter. To be clear, I'm not knocking TechSpot here. For basic, non-debatable product characteristics like color, weight, and dimensions, I generally take the manufacturer's word for it too, and I only double-checked this time because of the other peculiarities. Maybe marketing and PR isn't entirely to blame here though. Maybe they wouldn't have to scrape the bottom of the barrel to find stuff to say about their latest and greatest if it was a bit more greatest and a little less latest. So, and this is an honest question, what has the Blade team been doing for the last couple of years?
What we did was that we got the best thermals engineers, the same ones that worked on the Razer Blade, and have them look at the new Razer phone.
But I do have some good news. It's only been a few weeks, and it's a sample size of one, but I haven't experienced any of the issues from our previous blades on this unit. Even the weird color rendering issue that John found in Google Chrome appears to have been resolved. And as much of this video as I've spent criticizing it so far, the small iterative improvements to the blade have added up to a genuinely better product, especially for the user like me, who wants a portable machine that can game, but that generally uses it as more of a mobile workstation. battery life is much better thanks to definitely Intel and probably Nvidia fine-tuning their manufacturing processes. Mac system surface temperatures are basically unchanged, but the cool spot for WASD is bigger, which is nice. Performance in games actually improves a little bit. B6's GPU clocks higher and runs a few degrees cooler than V5, and the new touchscreen display really is a lot better. Now at this size, 4K resolution is irrelevant. In fact, I actually wish that it was 1440p at the max, because both of these panels are impossible to drive with a GTX 1060 in modern AAA games. But for general use, it's brighter, the air gap is smaller, improving off-axis clarity, and both color and contrast are so much better that last gen looks straight up washed out when placed side by side with the B6. This is equal parts criticism and praise, though. The difference here wouldn't be so striking if V5 wasn't using such an outdated panel. So then, it's better than ever before. I still love a lot about it. The keyboard is among my favorite. Thank God that horrendous one from the Blade Pro didn't make another appearance. Thunderbolt 3 for external add-in card support is great, and it looks and feels so deliciously premium. But it's 2017, and for gamers out there who want power and portability, the Blade isn't the only game in town anymore. So, in no particular order, here's what I want the Blade team to work on for the next 6 to 24 months to make B7 and B8 go from aging to awesome. 1. The webcam.
It's still decent, but it's no longer ahead of the pack, and streaming is at the heart of Razer's other product development.
2. Oh wow, that bezel. A 15-inch screen would be perfect here. Number 3. While I'm wishing for a custom display, it really should be 1440p and it should refresh at 120 hertz. 4. A 2-year standard warranty. This unit is great so far, but Razer, you guys really need to start standing behind your products better to rebuild my trust. And 5. I don't know, Dolby Atmos certification? That last one's not a huge deal, actually, and I mean, that's all I could think of to change, so obviously, I still love the Razer Blade, which is why it hurt so much when it cut me last year, and why I hate to see it getting rusty and neglected like this. Speaking of neglected, can I? Thanks to Man Outfitters for sponsoring this video and warming me up right now with this fantastic sweater. They're an online specialty retailer for premium men's apparel and accessories. They have some of the best products from the coolest brands and bring you a painless shopping experience. They have over 50 brands like Patagonia, Columbia, North Face, Yeti, and Sims. And I mean, you're already buying this stuff anyway, so you might as well get it all in one place. They offer free returns and exchanges, so it's risk-free. Stock up for winter now before all the best designs sell out. Simply select outerwear as your selection, browse for a design, then filter by color and size. So head over to www.manoutfitters.com/LinusTechTips and get a code for 10% off your next order. We'll have that linked in the video description. So thanks for watching, guys. If you disliked this video, hit that button. But if you liked it, hit like, get subscribed, maybe consider checking out where to buy the stuff we featured at the link in the video description. Also down there is our merch store, which has cool shirts like the one that I'm wearing under this one, as well as our community forum, which you should totally join. This is legitimately so much warmer right now.